rockcitynetworksandtonedeaf.com.au, coming to you from Face the Music 2011 here at the Arts Centre in Melbourne. And joining me, Daniel Bukowski. How are you, my friend?
I'm fantastic. A little bit jet lagged, yeah. But the good Australian beer will get me over that.
Okay. But with a coffee. It's the morning for coffees.
I need that, yeah, thing, yeah, to recover, because I had a too long night yesterday at Cubics, yeah. So there was a good DJ, and it's always like still this rock and roll, having good beer, partying, and then still working.
Yeah.
And the best thing in the morning is the coffee.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, well, everyone's got coffees here this morning. You can see them everywhere. They're doing a roaring trade down there. Now, you're the director for Popcom, and you also deal with the trade fair in Berlin, correct?
Yes.
Now, can you take us through the concept for Popcom and what it is for people out there that don't know what it is?
Okay. The Popcom is a B2B marketplace of this Berlin Music Week, the big music week like Melbourne Music Week in Berlin. And it's all about musicians, export offices from all over Europe, or even South Africa and India, going to Popcom and showing their bands, yeah, to other labels, promoters, or the press, to get them into Europe. Like, Berlin is, or Popcom is always the gate for bands to settle in Europe. When they really want to get out of their country, they come to Berlin and then spread over Europe. So it's a good time.
Yeah, yeah. Now, what's the breakdown of Popcom and how does it work exactly? Is it like film, and is there any sort of model compared to South by Southwest? Is it, or something similar?
We're getting more similar than we were before. But the problem is, like, Popcom was more industry like, yeah, and now the industry is struggling of this whole internet stuff like this, and so we're changing our concept slightly, into especially to doing the digital business on our conference and stuff like that, and we're now getting the musician in focus, how he can getting the crowd in the internet, how he can get out of this 1 million YouTube videos, why someone should click that one.
Yeah.
And so we try to give the bands information of how to do that, or the labels and stuff like that. So we're getting more digital and more like South by Southwest, because we want to have so many more bands to come to Popcom or to Berlin to show the music from the countries.
Excellent. Now, you were on a panel discussion for, was it Great Cities?
Yes.
Yeah, you're on the panel discussion for that. I think we've had all representatives today talking in interviews about that particular panel discussion. It seems to be popping up all around the venue. What did you take from that panel discussion, and sort of what did you give forward as a representative of Berlin?
No, it's like it's good to see that some cities do the same for the creative industry. Mm-hmm. I think, for example, I just can speak about Berlin, but in Berlin there's not much around. There's no factory, no manufacturing of cars or whatever. It's like Berlin is a creativity city. Like, there are so many creative people, not only musicians. There are people, painters, arts, young digital startups, or everybody who wants something new, away from old structures, are in Berlin. And so you meet them. You're not just only with musicians, but then on the other hand, at the bar, you're standing with one who's designing websites. So you talk to him, and then maybe you have the fantastic ideas to do the website with the musician, or with special music, or do some lights installation in some club in Kreuzberg. So that's so cool that the city support that and not lock them away. It's like, as we hear from the Council of Melbourne, it's like there was this evening business. No one in the politicians wanted to deal with that. Mm-hmm. But Berlin stands for that, for example, the club scene. People come from even Barcelona, coming with, for example, a Virgin flight in the morning, going to a club, partying all night long, and then flying back home to Barcelona. That's business. It's like people come for that to Berlin, yeah, spend money, buying taxis, getting something to eat. And so now it's great to see that lots of cities see that and support that.
Yeah, yeah. Now, can you tell us a little bit more about the trade fair? that you're involved in as well. That seems to be very interesting, and it seems to be very supportive from the younger age groups right up through to us and further, I guess. Can you take us through how that works?
So we have lots of export offices, they call, from all over Europe, like Sweden, Scandinavia, France, Spain, etc., who come with their bands or with their labels, with the companies to Popcom, and they meet each other and see how they can do business together. I have a good Swedish band who's very popular in Sweden, but in Spain no one knows her.
Mm-hmm.
How this band can be famous in Spain. So this is people talk about and then doing business. And I think it's very important, especially in this state of the time, that people start talk again,
mm-hmm.
like people talk about the experience and support each other. And this is what Popcom stands for, a big marketplace for the music business internationally in Europe, or even Africa, India, and stuff like that. We are not so strong in the American market, but we were getting there. And it's especially, as I said before, because of this digital business, because everything changed so fast, it's very important to meet once a year to talk about that and hear what's new and what I can do with my business.
Mm-hmm. Now, what have you taken from Face the Music so far, and what have you found to be the positives of this event?
That I'm here?
Yeah.
No,
well, it's a long
apart
way.
From
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That
you made it this morning.
I can't come tell you that. It's like, I always wake up at 3:30.
Yeah.
It's like, fuck, I look at the watch and say, no, I want to sleep.
Yeah.
But I think it's great to see that on the totally opposite side of the world, they're thinking the same. Like this Melbourne Music Week, like we had this Berlin Music Week, the second time, Melbourne Music Week, it's the second time, so we experience the same things, we have the same problems with some people and solving it in the same thing. So for me, it's good to see that it's not Berlin is not alone with that.
Yeah.
People all over the world thinking in the same direction, and then you know that you do something right. And I think this is the best thing for me that I can take home.
Yeah.
And apart from the good music you hear and good party meeting, catching up with interesting people and talking about the world music business, and that's fun.
Excellent, excellent. Well, Daniel, thank you very much for joining us here at Face the Music 2011. And if you want any more information on Popcom, I think it's popcom.de.
Or com, or C-O-M.
Okay, yep.
Or just give me a call.
Oh, we'll put it up there. We'll put your phone number up there and the website address.
I would look it for.
Are you sure? Are you sure you want me to do this?
Yes.
Okay.
I trust you on that.
All right. Trust is a very big word at this time of the morning when you're drinking coffee and it's been a bit.
Have another dip then.
Yeah, that's it. Have another one. It's Daniel Bukarski here from Popcom at Face the Music 2011 for Rock City Networks and ToneDeaf.com.au.